At start of 2023, we saw a set of projects to look out for from the folks at Blender Foundation. This comprised of a set of cool features that will be developed and planned for the future. And yes, we've seen the implementation of one of these, which is the viewport compositor, and has made it to the most recent release of Blender, which, to be candid, looks cool for a first official pass at a feature with such usefulness. Additionally, the folks at Blender Foundation have also made a few announcements, which include the change of the release schedule, which would now compensate on versioning and will give the developers more time to create rich features. We've also seen the new developmental infrastructure that the folks at Blender Foundation have also talked about, so for those who haven't taken a look at these, then you might want to consider checking those out. And as we get into the second quarter of 2023, the folks at Blender Foundation have announced in a new blog post a bit more of an additional plans for the future, and these deals with prioritized projects that will mainly concern developers at the Blender headquarters or those working off the development grant. And among the list of projects to be worked on are some impressive ones that we've all wanted to see come over to Blender. So if you simply go over to the link in the description, it's going to bring you right here where you can check these things out. The ones that are highlighted bold are the ones that are currently in active development or that have been recently implemented. Light linking is one of them, which is pretty new, and there's a video for that. There's also the simulation node, which was just recently announced, merging to main for Gris Pencil, SSS for EVNext, volume rendering for EVNext, and for Vulkan, the graphic pipeline, and also the compute pipeline and resource. And for those working with viewports, there is also the support for more nodes and the paint alley features. For UV, the UV packing is there, and for sculpting, there is a refactoring of the DIN topo, which we've come to love and use when sculpting in Blender. And for those wondering what the idea for character animation would be, this is something that has been covered in a previous post, and there are plans to revamp how character animation and also rigging would be like when working in Blender. So for those who didn't catch up with that, I'm going to put a link in the description that will take you over to where you can read up and see more stuff about this. And in the spirit of transparency, the folks at Blender Foundation has also put together a table that contains the weekly planning for this project. So right here, you can see the project, which includes cycles, the viewport, EVNext, Vulkan, brush asset, simulation nodes, extensions platform, Gris Pencil 3.0, character animation, sculpting, and UV improvements. So for cycles, there's a couple of things that they're thinking about working on, which we've actually seen some. One of them is the light linking, and this in itself is being used for the Studio Open Movie, which will be running from April all the way to middle of June. At the same time, they're looking at paint alley filters, the Gris Pencil integration, and some custom normals. Of course, you can see the team and also the admin in charge of this team. The same thing can be said for the viewport compositor, which will be running from now till sometime in June. And we can see EVNext, which would actually get its first merge into the alpha sometime in May, and bug fixes and stabilization will be happening from May till sometime in September. So hopefully, if everything works out, we'll be seeing EVNext before the year ends. Vulkan is currently being worked on, so for those who like to take a look at all of this, including simulation nodes which has now been added to Blender, all the way down to dynamic topology and UV unpacking, take a look at the spreadsheet and see some of the detailed information that is contained within the project that is being worked on by the folks at Blender Foundation. For those who have been thinking about catching up with some of the cool things that has been happening within the asset shelf or the draft system, then you might want to come through and read this up, as the brush asset project is being delayed and encountering unforeseen technical difficulties. Thus, the idea for the asset brush will be broken down into two categories, which includes the draft system for brushes and the asset shelf. And for cycles and the compositor, these projects have been developed and used in the current movie that the folks at Blender Foundation just recently announced. And for those who are thinking about catching up with the movie and seeing the implementation of procedural texturing, cycles, and also compositing, then you might want to go over to the folks at Blender Studio and take a peek behind the scenes. So this is it. For those who like to come through and take a look at some of the projects that will be taking off from the second quarter of 2023, then links to this is going to be in the description, so do well to check it out. Tell me what you guys think about this one in the comment section, and of course, if you like this video or you learned something from this, you can go ahead and give a like and don't forget to share with a friend. And until I see you guys in the next one, peace.